Yo, what's going down, everybody? It is Straight Out of Boston here, aka the King of Boston, and today we're back for episode 8 of the Rebuilding Project for season 1, aka the Chicago Cubs franchise, and we're fresh off of a sweep, a disappointing sweep at that, by the hands of the Atlanta Braves, so we're going to sim the rest of the postseason. Looks like Texas, Atlanta, and Atlanta won. So at least we lost the World Series champs. That's good. Alright. So, we're going to advance to the offseason. I don't really feel like checking anything. Contracts, hitting pitch coach, alright. Qualifying offers at 1.88. Giambi retired, cool. Big friggin' whoop. Alright. So let's manage contracts. We have some guys to re-sign / offer arbitration to. So, let's do a few of these big names first. We definitely want Harvey back. That's a no-brainer. So let's get him 5 years. Can we go to 7 mil? Nope. Default 6 years. Let's go 5 years player option. And we'll go all the way to, we'll go 8 mil. 5 years player option. Actually, he's 26. I can give him, whatever, we'll go 8.3. Hopefully he takes that. Mike Morris, I definitely want to get back, but, oh, he's not going to ask for too much money. Oh, yeah. All right. I only want Morris for, like, 2 years, though. Oh, he wants a, can we get him for 1 year? That'd be best case scenario. All right, see if he takes that. Kyle Lobstein, make an offer. Want him back. Go 3 years. There we go. Old arbitration, eligible. And we'll offer him arbitration that. And we should offer arbitration to Matt Harvey, too. We'll give Harvey arbitration salary of $5 million. Why not? Okay, and then the rest of you guys I'm going to go through on my own, so I'll be back. Alright, I'm back. Ryan's posting really racist jokes to me in my Skype, so if I start laughing randomly at some point. Alright, he's done. Okay, so we're like $5 million over in pending offers. We might have to do a salary dump trade here at some point. But I mainly just offered, you know, regular contracts to the guys. I didn't qualify Mike Gonzalez because really no point. He's not really any good, quite frankly. I mean, he's not good enough to get that much money to earn a qualifying offer of whatever we need to get a draft pick back. All right, so get most of our guys back. Really want Harvey to resign. I don't think he will. If you guys are recognized, though. If we don't get Harvey, we can just offer him arbitration, though. And maybe that'll put us under the budget. That'd be nice. So, let's simulate through date. And check out who's some available. Oh, wait. What was our budget increase? I'm just assuming it was, like, 10%. Yeah. Okay. So, we can't afford any of these guys, but that's fine. Jesus, Harvey's. Just curious to see. Yeah, that's never going to happen. We do not have that. Yep. No chance of Bautista. At least 35. I really wouldn't want Bautista. Although I think the new patch is coming into effect because these guys, or Bautista didn't decline as much. He didn't decline like 30,000 points or something. Weeders would be awesome, but that's never going to happen. Yeah, we really just don't have the money. So I really want Harvey back. So I want to up his offer to 8.5 with a player option. Oh, okay. I can't afford it, of course. Okay, yeah, we can't sign any of these guys, which is too bad. Although we do need, we might need another, an extra outfielder, like a kind of a fourth outfielder type guy. But I really don't think so, actually, because we're gonna call up Jackie Bradley and them. So, yeah, I don't think we're gonna make any offers to anyone. So, I'm just seeing who we could potentially trade here to dump salary. Don't want to trade any of these guys after that. I mean, maybe Mike Morris. I might trade Mike Morris. Just because, I don't know. I feel like we have better options. I could play Bradley instead. So you might trade Mike Morris. I'm not really too sure. I don't know what we could get for him. Considering half the freaking MLB isn't even under contract. But that's alright. What could we use? Maybe a catcher? Hidalgo's good, but he's not like amazing. Perez. Yeah, I don't know. I might have to search through some offers. We'll see. I think we'll just keep simulating for now. This is the date I think we have to get our 40-man roster set, so I think we'll just simulate through here, maybe try to make some trades later in the offseason. Anyway. So, okay, here's the date we gotta set our 40-man. So let's go all... Ah, what am I doing? Let's check our potentials. 40-man. So Nathaniel Jones is on... I'm assuming most of these guys are. He's not. I bet Jones isn't even. Yeah, fuck me. It's alright. Probably want those guys on there anyway. Leo Rodriguez is ineligible. Vickers. Alright, I imagine really no one past this is going to be eligible. Yeah, okay. So should be good. And then this is the final data tender player. So we'll simulate to here. Actually, we'll probably simulate to the Rule 5 draft. And then see what happens. I just really want Matt Harvey back, and then maybe we'll make a trade. We'll see. I might... no, we won't simulate. I wonder... I'm thinking I might want to trade one of my pitchers. Just because we do have some talent coming up through the system. We have Kyle Loebstein as well. And I'm just thinking... I don't even know. I'm trying to think of ways we can improve the team. Like, I think our team's pretty solid. But, you know, I just don't know. Wow, some good guys available. Really, potential doesn't matter at this point. All these guys are pretty old. Like, it's Zach Braddock. Braddock. Or... I don't know, any names that I actually recognize? Jared Cozart. He's 25. Yeah, I don't recognize any of these names. Taiwan Walker. Guess he's not on the 40-man roster. Alright, we might take this guy. Add another arm, probably to the bullpen. Let's see who's better, him or Braddock? Oh, Braddock's way better. Yeah, we'll get Zach Braddock. Braddock, whatever his name is. Third straight year, we got a reliever out of the Rule 5 draft. And we're just going to skip. Skip selection. And we're done. Okay. Exit the Rule 5 draft. So, ooh, the Padres got Justin Upton. What? Holy shit, Papelbon. Oh, I want Matt Harvey back, but... Cubs unsigned players. Really have that much in pending offers? It's all Harvey's. That's the thing. We definitely want these guys back. And then I'll probably just renew all their contracts. I can renew Loebstein. So I'm going to offer Loebstein like a really shitty deal. We'll go 1 year. At like the very minimum. And he won't accept it. And then we'll just renew his contract. Olt, we can offer arbitration. I don't know how much he's going to make though. We might just trade Olt at some point. And let's keep offering Harvey more money. I mean, offering him an extra million doesn't really kill. Because we can't even afford it's the thing. Alright, I'm just going to search around. If I find deals that I like, then I'll be back. If not, then I guess I'll be back anyway. But yeah, okay. So, alright, so I'm back. We're at the start of February. I didn't really make any trades. I'm going to wait until we get... trades to the like spring training or whatever to make trades just so that more guys are under contract. So we have a few arbitration dates. It's Mike Olds and Matt Harvey's. I'm dreading Matt Harvey's because I really think he's going to get a sheetload of money. Swisher. Wow, it's on the cheap. That's the thing. He's like, he's just as good as Mike Olt. Oh, my. Or not Mike Olt. Morris. Wow. That's too bad, man. I want to trade more so bad. Whatever. Okay, so let's simulate through here. I'm not going to be able to re-sign either of those guys. That's fine. I also need to renew Kyle Loebstein's contract. Olt's gonna get... Okay, not too much. That's good. Harvey's gonna make a lot. Okay, 7 mil. That's fine. And let's renew. Why can't I just freaking renew? I have to wait till, like, the last day. It's so weird. Whatever. Anyway. Cubs level. Yeah, I don't have the money to re-sign them, I don't think. Let's go to manage contracts. Renew. For the freaking minimum, we're so over the budget. Okay. So we're not too far over the budget, but we definitely need to think about making some trades here. Edwin Mason, Ziegler, Cabrera. Okay. Anyway, Ethan Adcock. So this is also the thing. I think I want to trade Mike Morris so that I can. Oh, I guess Bradley can DH, but. I still want to trade Mike Morris. Because Jorge Soler is getting up there, too. And, yeah, 76 overall. So. Yeah, we're going to try and trade. Yeah, and after Scherzer's rookie year, it's hard to keep him on the bench. So we're going to try and trade Mike Olt, probably. Yeah, alright, so I'll be back. Alright, so here's a really cool trade that I think I kind of accidentally stumbled upon. I don't know. I mean, I'm going to do it. I'm just trying to kind of fiddle around with it, see if there's other options that I have. But I think I want to get rid of Soler, so we're getting Will Myers. He's 87 overall, A potential. He's only 25 years old. Still some room to grow. Definitely going to be up there in the 90s at some point. We're getting rid of Morris. Old. Like I said, I kind of just want to get rid of his contract. And we're going to get rid of Soler because, you know, just that way Myers doesn't really have any competition left. And then they'll do this for Taiwan Walker, which I'm really surprised by considering he's B potential. He must be getting close to A potential or something because they won't take any other Bs. They only want As. And I just don't have a place for Walker with you know, Wheeler and them and yeah, so, we can get this guy, too. I think we'll do that. And not him, but if there's any relievers that are good, we're not going to be able to get, like, any of these guys. Yeah, Martinez down to B potential. Okay. So, yeah, we're going to do this deal. Pretty good deal, I think. Get Will Myers. It's really cool. And then I think I'm going to... I gotta trade one of these guys because either that or what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna package Wheeler, Barnes, and Barrera or something for another good starter, a cheap guy though, because like I have so much pitching depth down here, so I need to do something. So we'll be back. All right, so here's the deal that I'm gonna do. Matt Barnes. He's up to 25 years old now, and he's really never had a good year for us. And we're giving up this second base prospect, which we really don't need since Watanabe's only 20 years old, and he's a friggin' stud. He's a stud amongst studs. And this guy, he's really 20 years old. He played like almost every position, which is a big bonus. But getting Dan Straley, he's only B potential, but that's all right, because he's already 27, so it doesn't look like he's going to be progressing too much anymore. He's one of my favorite pitchers in baseball, and he's obviously cheap, so... that helps out better than Barnes, and it's just overall worth it type of deal. But I'm still going to be trying to wheel and do a little bit. If I could do as much as I like Skaggs, maybe we'll keep Skaggs. But if I could do like, I don't know, I'm still going to try and do something here. We'll see. All right, so I don't think I'm going to make any more deals. Our pitching is friggin' beastly as it is. When your fifth starter is 85, that's pretty good. Then we got, I think we'll have to put Wheeler in the bullpen. Kind of have to see where he fits in. But Myers definitely going to start. He'll hit probably, yeah, I think fifth is good for him. And then Bradley out of the two hole. Question is he going to field? Yes, he will. Actually, we should probably put Olt at DH kind of a little bit more. realistic, so to say. So who has better arm strength? 68. 66. So not a big difference there. Chat. Whoa! No. Who did I have starting center field last year? Wait. I swear I had, like, a good center fielder. I guess it was just Scherzer. Whatever. Scherzer. Huh. Really? Am I dumb? Did I lose someone at free agency? I don't know, man. But I guess... We'll probably put Scherzer out there. Oh, you know what? I guess it's because when we play the AL teams, we have the DH. That's what's throwing me off. Okay, we're going to have Scherzer out there. We'll put Bradley. Fuck. Put Bradley ninth in this case. Yeah, Old can DH. Here, Myers in. And then Bradley over Jackson. And then, in this case, we'll put Bradley in center. We should probably, yeah, we'll do this. Keep Bradley in center all the time. So pretty much same thing here, except Myers moves to left, so Old can play right. So in that case, we'll switch these two. Okay. I just like having consistency throughout. So here. Yeah. There we go. And then DHing. As much as Coast, as good as Coast is, Scherzer, it's just much better. So once again, Old's gonna DH, Scherzer in right. I want to try and duplicate the lineup, so. Okay. And then Myers, Bradley. I have big expectations for Bradley. He's had a good few years. Or whatever, in the short, I'm getting spammed on Skype, that's distracting me, so I apologize, guys. I probably shouldn't be on Skype, but what are you gonna do? Okay, and then pitching rotation, just throw Australia in there, we'll be good. Two lefties, that's good. And then, yeah, that's set. So I think what we might do is put Wheeler, because I feel like Wheeler, he's 25, he needs to be in the bigs. So we're going to send down probably Ardios Vizcaino. Oh, no, Alberto Cooper. Oh, but he's already on. Yeah, okay. So we're going to send down Vizcaino, even though he has to go through waivers. Also, I'd be surprised if he got claimed, quite frankly. So we're going to make Wheeler a mid. Keep Lovestein there. Because Lovestein's not going to progress anymore, really. Well, probably Wheeler isn't either, but whatever. We need a righty, so. Okay, that's going to wrap this up. So I think we'll play maybe this Nationals game or the Giants. Could play with Australia against Taiwan. We might do that. But I do like simulating ahead a little bit just to see how the team does. So I think we'll play this Nationals game. Or Miami. Maybe. Who's on Miami? No one good, right? Yeah, they're still pretty bad. Nationals. Let's play the Marlins. We're going to play Miami. Okay, so let's simulate. Hope no one dies. Cabrera made it. All right, cool. Cool. We're terrible. Oh, wait, was that the R Cubs? Okay, must have been the Triple A Cubs. Alright. I'm surprised. I should have made Hudson our opening day pitcher. Considering going Cy Young last year. Alright, we're terrible. We're so bad. Oh, okay. At least Anderson's not terrible. Alright, really? Wow. We better turn things around. Anderson's our only good pitcher. I'm going to use Straley if I can. I have a feeling Straley's going to pitch this last. Oh, no. He's going to pitch the last freaking. No. Okay. We're going to play this Washington game then. Because I want to pitch with Straley. Okay. So we're terrible, but it's all right. So we're going to play this Nationals game. And I'll see you guys in the highlights.
Today's matchup on the show will be Nationals at Cubs from the friendly confines of Wrigley Field. You can see the players getting a little chatter together on the field before the game. Jackie Bradley and Tyler Colvin, two young studs for this team, as well as Starlin Castro. Bottom of the third, base is loaded for Anthony Rizzo. He takes it into deep right field. That one is belted, and you can kiss it goodbye. A grand slam for Anthony Rizzo. And the Cubs jump out to an early 4-0 lead by an Anthony Rizzo's grand slam. He has not hit the ball so well against left-handed pitching so far this season. However, he did a good job right there. So now, later in the game, Ryan Zimmerman is up. Dan Straley was on the mound for the Chicago Cubs today, and he was straight balling. He was perfect through 7 innings before it was broken up in the 8th, but it was still a very great performance out of Dan Straley, the new acquisition for the Chicago Cubs. But Derek Holland would also settle down here. He is going to get Mike Holt to swing and miss on the curveball right there for the strikeout, and Holland would really settle down. But now, bottom of the 5th, 3-0 count to that man again, Anthony Rizzo. He takes that one to deep right field. That one is going to hook fair ball, and is going to get picked up by the right fielder, but not before one run will score. There will be a play at the plate, but the throw was offline, so one run scores. Rizzo's into third for a RBI triple. And that would be it for Derek Holland. He would get pulled right there. So we skip ahead to the top of the 8th inning, and Danny Espinosa is going to take that one over Starlin Castro's head. Greg Burke was on the mound for the Chicago Cubs. This one is going to play not just one run, but two. A 2 RBI double for Danny Espinosa, so the Nationals would get on the board, but the score was 7-2 at this point, and the Nationals' comeback would prove to be not worth it. As you're going to see, Zach Braddock on the mound for the Cubs. He's going to get Tyler Colvin to pop up to center field right there, and that will end your ball game. So the Chicago Cubs end up taking this one 7-2. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you did enjoy, and Zoza's out. Peace!